9 because I think I'm babysitter.
All right, and I know that probably can be really stressful trying to, I mean, I talked about that before, getting everything settled with the different roles that you have.
Yeah, it can, it's challenging as a student to balance homeroom plus school.
Yeah, well, we're excited to have her with us, and we're glad that you could find a way to kind of relieve that stress and still be here with us tonight. That's awesome. So let's start off with just someone volunteering to tell us how their week was.
You know what's inside?
Anyone?
It's hard to
keep. I think that this past week has been even more stressful because finals are coming up for a lot of us, and the stress load before that is, I would say, over a 10. I think after this it'll be better.
That's good. I'm glad to hear that it'll be declining soon. Does anyone else feel that way? So we can all kind of agree that maybe a heavy load right now, whatever. That'll be nice to kind of get it over with. So with all the stresses coming with finals, what did you all do to cope this week? I know the homework was to talk about coping and about the things that we did well and things that we maybe didn't do so well. Would anyone want to start?
I'm trying to take more breaks. Just because I was so stressed, I didn't really work out because I have so much stuff to do. So
yeah. What about things that maybe you did do well,
Dean? I don't know. I don't really think I did anything well.
No, maybe we can work on that some more today. Elizabeth, what about you?
Well, this week has been more stressful because Northern has like all the projects are due this week and then next week. And plus, like, what about my mom with that and my brother all with it? Especially like weather's been really bad out, so I didn't even like kind of get away from everybody. So it's like no matter where I went, there was always somebody there. It was hard to think. Yeah, I needed the quiet, which I didn't get a lot of.
Yeah. You can mute here, right? So it might be a little bit harder for you to get that quiet space. Does anyone else have trouble getting that kind of quiet time?
I'm okay.
Yeah, that can be difficult.
Even on campus, like that's something that as far as for me, I mean, in your dorms or your library, anywhere if you go, you can't get quiet, so that just adds to the stress.
Yeah. Is there anything you could do to kind of deal with that issue? Does anyone have any ideas?
Elizabeth, some things that I do is, like, I know there's some private study rooms and some buildings in here, and so I try to go there, or if there is a time where nobody is in my dorm, I'll just stay in there and stay put for a while, and that seems to help, but.
Yeah. I think that could be really helpful, or maybe when no one's home, try to get your studying in and then. Communicate with your family that you need a lot of time. That might help. So does anyone else want to say what they might have done well this week?
I love this year. I was wasn't that good on a necklace.
Well, I kind of balance out, like, you know, spending time more with my family, especially my dad. And study too for like tests and science coming up. He still just didn't understand, so he didn't even like really work out and help.
Yeah.
So, I don't know what else to do to reach out to him.
Yeah, I think it's great that you took that step and doing something that you maybe weren't so comfortable doing. Trying to communicate that with him. I think it's important to remember that we can only change our actions and our behaviors, so just keep doing what is right. And I think your dad will probably see that you're making an effort, and eventually his behavior will change too. Does anyone else want to share anything with someone? So, we're going to get out these pieces of paper. And I'm going to have you all write down just some that are kind of happening right now in your life, some things that are weighing on you, whether they be tasks, responsibilities, assignments, work, finances, anything like that. If you could just make a list, I'm going to pass the paper around. Here, I'll pass this way. Seconds to kind of get those farm logs. Also, sorry for teaching. It's okay.
Sophia. That's Sophia.
So, Sarah, if we could start with you, maybe if you want to share a couple of those, some things that are kind of stressing you out.
Well, like I was saying earlier, I think schoolwork would be the biggest stressor. But then also, another big thing is balancing everything. I felt overwhelmed a lot this week because I still had to work on top of that extra homework, and then I still wanted time with my friends, and then time to rest, and I think that's really overwhelming, like you don't feel like you have enough time, and it has made me more tired, and I think that was, there were a lot of stressors this week.
Do you want to share a couple things on your list?
So dealing with homework and finals has been stressful. We're closing our mortgage this week. And I'm still looking for a place to do my field for school. So I've been trying to figure out what those agents and how much they're going to be doing on that thing.
Yeah. And then I think we're seeing again the role of being a wife and a mother coming together with the school roles. I think that's really interesting that you're able to do that. Do you have any news on your house?
We're closing Saturday. Something that is really heavy on my mind is getting ready for my practical. I'm trying to get everything set up and I think I have my own place, but it's hard to get in touch with the person and to meet with them and to fill out the paperwork and stuff. And then going to the practical, I'm like, having no time to really get to me. He looks full of drama and full of things I'm losing my scholarship.
And that's really what I struggle on. Not on my dad's relationship on top of that.
You know, that has to be hard. Is there anyone else kind of worried about maybe what how school's gonna look for you in the future or anything like that? Or that can be hard.
Well, I thought about jumping right back in and applying for graduate school after this, but with it being a mother and stuff, and then we're moving into a new town, so I'll be like, I don't know what my plans look like right now. I think that's so kind of stressful, just like the unknown.
Right. I think that it sounds like maybe you're both kind of dealing with, you have these goals, but you don't know if you're going to be able to get to those goals right now and what that's going to look like.
Mm-hmm.
I definitely think it sounds like you have your priorities in line. You're so concerned about your family and those relationships, but you're also concerned about your future. And I think that you guys are both going to make really good decisions and get far. Just try not to let it overwhelm you that all this is going on. If you all would, if you could, when you go home, make a number of these and put them in order. Just kind of saying like what is the most urgent and what you can kind of put off. And something that has really helped me has been making like a planner, a time slot for each thing that I need to get done and trying to kind of schedule that in. And sometimes that's not always definite, but I think that it can really be beneficial. So if you could just fit these into your time slots and then write down your coping mechanisms that you use again, and when we come back next time, we're going to talk about that. Is there anything else that you all can think of that you think might help us become better at coping with stress?
I think just better time management. I think that's one thing that I've learned about being a parent, just how you're just planning out your day and making a time for each thing, especially like small children, they have to be on a schedule, like bath time, same time every night, bedtime, same time, dinner time. So I try to keep her on a schedule. I notice like if she's not on her schedule, that can really, it really affects her in her day.
Do you think that maybe we're like that too with our schedules?
I know I am. Like, I don't like, I don't like spur of the moment, like, type things. Like, the plan things.
So, do you think maybe if you set a time to get responsibilities done, if we maybe did that, that you might be more likely to accomplish those tasks?
Mm-hmm, I think so, definitely.
Well, I hope this exercise helps then. Just make sure that you all write it.